Hello there and welcome to my channel. I'm Marie. Today I'm going to teach you how to crochet this beautiful popcorn flower granny square. It's quite easy and simple to make, and I think it's just so adorable with these cute popcorn petals here. So just grab some yarn and a hook and let's get started. To begin, we are going to make a magic circle. So I'm going to wrap my yarn around my two fingers and create a cross. Then I'll take my hook and insert it underneath the bottom yarn, grab the top yarn, yarn over, and pull through the loop on the hook. So here is my magic circle, and I'm going to make 8 single crochet into the circle. So I'm going to insert my hook, pull up a loop, yarn over, and pull through 2 loops. And again, 7 more times. And as I work my stitches, I'm just going to pull my yarn tail to make the circle a little bit smaller. So that's 8 single crochet, and I'm going to pull my yarn tail one last time to close it. But I'm not going to close it completely, so I'm leaving a little hole here. And to end the round, I'm going to make a slip stitch into this first stitch here. So insert, pull up a loop, pull through the loop on the hook. And to start the second round, I'm going to chain 3. 1. 2 and 3, and these 3 chains will count as the first double crochet of the round. So next I'm going to make 3 more double crochet into the same stitch. So yarn over, insert, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, and pull through 2. And again, 2 more times. So I now have what counts as 4 double crochet, so I'm going to take out my hook and I'm going to insert it into the top of these chain 3. Then I will take this loop here and place it on the hook and pull it through. So here's the first popcorn stitch. And next I will chain 2. 1 and 2. Into the next stitch I will again make 4 double crochet. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Again, I will take out my hook and insert it into the first stitch and then place the loop here on the hook and pull it through. So again, a cute little popcorn stitch. Then chain 2. And I will just continue all the way around until I have 8 popcorn stitches in total. So again, 4 double crochet into the same stitch. Then take out the hook, insert it into the first stitch, place the loop on the hook, and pull through. And chain 2 and continue around. And here at the end, just chain two and make a slip stitch here into the first top of the chain three. And I will make a slip stitch into this next chain space here. So to start the third round, I'm going to chain three. And again, the chain three will count as the first double crochet. So next I'm going to make three more double crochet into the same chain space here. And again, take out my hook and insert it into the top of the chain three. Place the loop on the hook and pull through. And then chain two. So next I'm going to make one more popcorn stitch into the same chain space here. So again, make four double crochet. Then take out the hook, insert it into the first stitch, place the loop on the hook, and pull through. And again, chain two. Again, I will make two popcorn stitches into this next chain space. So, four double crochet into the same space. And make the popcorn stitch, then chain two, and again, one more popcorn stitch into the same space. So four double crochet. And insert into the first stitch, place the loop on the hook and pull it through and chain two. And I will just repeat that all the way around. So I will make two popcorn stitches and chain two in every chain space all the way around. And at the end of the round, I will have 16 popcorn stitches. And here at the end, I will just chain two again and make a slip stitch into this first chain three here. And this is what my work looks like when I am done with round three. So I'm just going to fasten off my yarn here. So I will pull my yarn and cut and tie a little knot. To add a new color of yarn, I'm just going to insert my hook into any one of the chain spaces and pull my yarn through and tie a knot. And then I'm going to insert my hook, pull up a loop, and chain four. One, two, three, and four. And here in round four, we are going to turn this circle into a square. So I'm going to make the first corner of the square here into the first space. And the chain four will count as the first treble crochet of the round. So next I'm going to make two more trebles into the same space. So I'm going to yarn over twice, insert my hook, pull up a loop,
yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. And again, yarn over twice, insert, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. And to create the corner, I'm going to chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3. And then I will make 3 more trebles into the same space. So again, yarn over twice, insert, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. And 2 more into the same space. And next I'm going to chain 1. And into the next space here, I will make 3 double crochet. So 1, 2, and 3. Again, chain 1. And into the next space, 3 half double crochet. So yarn over, insert, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 3 loops. And again, 2 more times. And chain 1. Next, I will again make 3 double crochet into the next space. And chain 1. I'm now going to make the next corner of the square. So again, I will make 3 trebles, chain 3, and 3 trebles into the same space. So again, yarn over twice, insert, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. And again, 2 more times. Then chain 3. And again, 3 more trebles into the same space. And then chain 1. And from here, I'm just going to continue all the way around. So I'm going to make the sides of my square just like I did before. And I will make the corners also as I did right here. So again, 3 double crochet into the next space. Chain 1, 3 half double crochet into the next space. Chain 1, and I'm just going to hide my yarn tail here behind the stitches, and again make 3 double crochet into the next space. And chain 1, and make the next corner. And again, chain 1 and make the next side of the square just like before. So 3 double crochet, chain 1, 3 half double crochet, chain 1, and 3 double crochet into the third chain. And again, chain 1 and make the last corner of the square. So again, 3 trebles. And chain 3. And 3 more trebles into the same space. And chain 1 and make the next side just like before. And at last here, I will just chain 1 and make a slip stitch into the top of the chain 4. So insert and pull through. Now, if you are satisfied with the size of your square, you can just cut your yarn right here, but I'm just going to add another round. So I'm just going to make a slip stitch into the next stitch and into the next and into the next chain space. And I will start with making the first corner. So I will chain 3. And the chain 3 will count as the first double crochet of the round. I will then make 2 more double crochet into the same space. So it's just like the classic granny square, if you know how to make that. 3 double crochet, and then chain 2, and 3 more double crochet into the same space. And then chain 1 and make 3 double crochet into the same space. And again, chain 1 and make 3 double crochet into the next 3 spaces. And chain 1 in between. So 3 double crochet, chain 1, and 3 double crochet. Then chain 1 and make the next corner of the square. So 3 double crochet, chain 2, and 3 double crochet into the same space. Chain 2 and 3 double crochet. And I'm just going to continue this way all the way around. So for the sides of the square, I'm just going to chain 1 and make a cluster of 3 double crochet into every chain space and chain 1 in between each cluster. So 3 double crochet into every chain space. And chain 1 in between. And again, chain 1 and make the next corner just like before. So 3 double crochet, chain 2, and 3 double crochet into the same space. And just continue around. And here at the end of the round, I'm just going to chain 1. And make a slip stitch into the top of the chain 3. and I will fasten off my yarn. And all that's left to do now is just to weave in the yarn tails on the back side of the square. And that is it. We are all done. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video. And if you found this video helpful, please give this video a like, comment down below, and subscribe to the channel if you would like to see a lot more of my crocheting tutorials. I really hope to see you next time. Have a wonderful day. Bye for now.